Class 8, it's time to continue chapter number 6, The Great Uprising of 1857. Okay, in the previous class or in the previous video, we studied about the various causes for the revolt of 1857, the Great Uprising, right? Now, in today's class, we are going to start about the different leaders, important leaders, and the spread of the uprising as well as the consequences of the revolt of 1857. So let's start today's class. The immediate cause of revolt of 1857, the company introduced, company means Britishers. Britishers introduced Enfield rifle in the Indian army. Now the grease cartridge were to be used in this rifle, new rifle. Right, so now the soldiers had to buy the end of that cartridge, but it was rumored that the cartridge was greased with the fats of cows and fats of cows and pigs. Both Hindu and Muslim soldiers resented the use of these cartridges, why they regarded it as an attempt to pollute their religion, because cow is a sacred animal for Hindu and pig considered as unclean animal for Muslims. So for both Hindu and Muslim, both Hindu and Muslims soldiers, they were unhappy and they refused to use the Enfield rifle. So this feeling produced a spark to inflame the uprising of 1857. The use of greased cartridges became the immediate cause of this national event. Now next topic is leaders and spread of the uprising. Mangal Pandey was the first Brahmin soldier or sepoy who refused to use the greased cartridge which was introduced by the company, by the Britishers. So on 29th March 1857, Mangal Pandey, a Brahmin sepoy means soldier at Barrackpore, refused to use this Enfield rifle, right? And when he was forced to do so, he flew up in the rage and killed two English soldiers. He was arrested and later on he was tried and executed also. The execution of Mangal Pandey sparked off revolts in Meerut, Delhi, Kanpur, Jhansi, Lucknow, Banaras, Awadh, Bareilly, Gwalior and other places in the northern and the central India. So these are the events of the Great Uprising. Now first is let's talk about the Meerut. After the incident of hanging of Mangal Pandey, when he was hanged, sepoys of the regiment at Meerut refused to do the army drill using the new cartridges. 85 sepoys were dismissed from services and sentenced to 10 years in jail for disobeying their officers because they refused to do the army drill, right, using the new cartridges. The soldiers marched to the jail in Meerut and released all the prisoners from the jail in Meerut, and they attacked and killed several British officers and sepoys also, and they captured guns and ammunitions and set fire to the buildings and properties of the British and declared war on the Firangis. So the word Firangis here mean the British soldiers or Britishers, Firangis. Right, so they declared war on Firangis, Britishers. The soldiers were determined to bring an end to this rule. This rule means company's rule, Britishers' rule in the country. Now, next is event at Delhi. Let's talk about the event at Delhi. So the soldiers who started this revolt from Meerut, they went on marching towards And Bahadur Shah Zafar, who was the last Mughal ruler, he led revolt from at Delhi, right? So even an unrest prevailed in the religious circles to overthrow the British from India. That is why the soldiers from the adjoining cities or adjoining areas, they also joined, local soldiers, they also joined this revolt. Now, consequently, this changed into a revolutionary war, but later on, Sir John Nicholson, he became successful in suppressing this revolutionary movement. With the help of Sikh rulers of Punjab, and in September 1857, he was able to recapture Delhi, right? The company was successful in recapturing the company in 1857. So in this war, Bahadur Shah Zafar, he was imprisoned and sent to Rangoon into jail, and where he died in 1862. A number of Indians were murdered under the rule of General Neill, and the sons of Bahadur Shah were also killed before his eyes. Now, next is event at Kanpur. At Kanpur, Nana Saheb, who was denied to give his pension by the Britishers, declared himself as a Peshwa and led the rising. So from Kanpur, Nana Saheb led the revolt, and he was very unhappy with the Britishers because he was refused to give pension of his father's pension because he was adopted son of Peshwa Bajirao II, right? So he was later he was actually initially he was promised to give his father's pension, but later on Britishers denied his pension by the Britishers. So he was very unhappy with the Britishers and declared himself as a Peshwa and led the revolt at Kanpur. His sepoys killed several British men and women mercilessly and expelled the British troops also from Kanpur. Being a great patriot and skillful in guerrilla warfare, his commander Tantya Tope won the glory. But the English troops under General Havelock took the revenge of it and murdered a number of Indians. So Nana Saheb ran away to Nepal and escaped being imprisoned by the Britishers, by the English. So here one important term is there, that is a guerrilla warfare. GUERILLAWARFARE. Guerrilla warfare. So I think about this I already told you in the previous chapter also. So underline that word, guerrilla warfare. So this the meaning of guerrilla warfare, you are going to write yourself, right? Now, next is event at Lucknow. Begum Hazrat Mehl of Awadh, who was the regent of her son, led the rising at Lucknow with the help of disbanded soldiers of Awadh. Begum Hazrat Mehl, she besieged Sir Henry Lawrence and the other officials in the residency. So besieged means she attacked from all sides. She attacked the residency of Henry Lawrence and the other officials from all the sides, right? And she shot dead sent Henry Lawrence, although General Havelock came to help the English troops, but he failed to do so, right? So General Neill also murdered in this uprising, and at last Sir Colin Campbell became successful in suppressing the rising made by the revolt made by Begum Hazrat Mehl, and
is successful in recapturing Lucknow again, right? So the Begum Hazrat Mahal, she fled to Nepal and escaped being captured from the Britishers, the company, right? Okay, now next is Central India. Central India, Rani Lakshmi Bai and her general Tantya Tope led the revolt. She fought very courageously and very bravely and fearlessly, but due to the traitors in her own camp, she defeated by the English forces, right? She defeated by the company. And Rani Lakshmibai, she ran to Kalpi. The English general Sir Hugh Rose followed both Rani Lakshmibai and Tantya Tope, and from Kalpi she went to Gwalior and seized it from Sindhia, who was a great supporter of the company of the Britishers, right? And Rani Lakshmibai died fighting in the battlefield, and Tantya Tope was captured and sentenced to death. With the death of Rani Lakshmibai and Tantya Tope, the revolt of 1857 came to an end, because there was no other such fearless leaders like Rani Lakshmibai, Tantya Tope, and there were no other leaders like them, right? So with the death of Rani Lakshmibai and the death of Tantya Tope, the revolt of 1857, the uprising of 1857, that came to an end, right? Okay, now next topic is the rising of 1857, unprecedented. The revolt of 1857 was unprecedented. Unprecedented means unknown, or surprisingly took place, right? So this is due to the various reasons. Number one reason is the rising was very fast in its speed and very wider in its extent, right? And the people of all caste and religion, they participated in this uprising, leaving behind all their differences. All the people, whether they were peasants, landlords, princes, or educated, uneducated, farmers, women, children, all were affected by the uprising of 1857. The foundation of the company was shaken by the this uprising. So the foundation, the very foundations, was shaken by the this revolt, this uprising. According to some historian, it was the first rising against the British rule, which was carried on with a planning. So it was that revolt. So I told you in the previous video also that this revolt was also known as the First War of Independence, right? So this was the first time in the Indian history that the all Indians, they got united and they fought against the Britishers, and which carried with the planning, right? With the planning. So some historians told that this uprising was against the Britishers for the first time in the Indian history, and which was carried on with a planning, right? Which that is why it shook the foundation of the British rule in India. So children, that's all for the day. We'll continue this chapter in the next video, and hopefully we'll start a new chapter, right? So till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye bye.